about. Why am I even being that dramatic? It's 2 days to Christmas. And I'm trying to be super, super nice. I'm not trying to be the Grinch this Christmas. So I'm going to say before that, the whole store starts, the whole what? Before the show starts, a merry, merry, merry Christmas from us to you and yours. We can't stress that hard enough. Merry Christmas. Now that put aside, welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Well, you know, everybody jumped onto my social media. As soon as this whole cat situation blew out like this, everybody jumped on my social media. And everybody, for some reason, wanted to hear my take on the cat situation. Now, in case, which I highly doubt, even if you're under what rock, you would know what happened. In case you did know though, because it's my job to inform, MC Cat came out and there was this video that was going viral before the other three videos. There was the first video of him at Fame, and he was outrightly saying, I'm HIV positive and I have pneumonia. And then just hours after that, videos of him started circulating on different social media platforms. I actually got my first chance to see them on, what's the thing called? It was on Twitter first? Joseph, was it on Twitter? It's a drop. Just my straps. Anyway, okay. He came out, the first video, and said he's HIV positive. Before that, and on top of that, he told us Aliku International Medicine. And I was like, okay, Butang, slow it down, slow your roll. Next thing we know, there's these videos of him while he was in the UK, and he's crying, and he's depressed, and he's saying all these things of frustration, that he's running cuckoo, that he's hurting, he's done, he's tired, natandiko gabebi into. Okay. Y'all want to hear my honest opinion. What? I feel like what MC Cats did was really, really selfish. It was really, really selfish. He could have composed himself in a better way if all he wanted was sympathy or empathy, or if he wanted just for the world to know that AIDS is real. I believe he could have humbled himself down, reached out to any one of these media platforms, sat down and had him a good old press conference like every regular folk and say it out the way it is. But one, he said it out in a bar. Two, I am feeling very conflicted regarding the fact that after he says it in a bar and then all these videos are dropping. Three, I am still confused and perplexed by that chick with the brown thighs who is in the videos recording. Like, this guy literally has a knife to his neck. Okay, it doesn't matter. That's a butter knife. And maybe that butter knife in particular could have taken his life. But guys showing you he's a mess, he's a wreck, he's all these things, and you're still holding your phone, recording him. And what's even worse is that I actually felt like MC Cats knew at that moment that he was being recorded. So the theatrics and the drama came out. Why do I say it is selfish? One, there's people who are involved in this too. When you come out and say you're HIV positive, you have to understand your partner for the past couple of years was also in that equation of you saying it. And she hadn't said anything until last evening when she came out and said whatever it is that she said. Look here, guys. The thing here is not HIV/AIDS. That shouldn't even be. We have been fighting the scourge for the longest time ever. We have been very vocal about stopping the stigma. We have been very vocal as a nation, by the way. And as a people, you know, AIDS is real. But this whole thing, I don't even know what to say. I don't know what to go by, because there's another aspect in the fact that he has an upcoming chivuru. Katibu enjo get deko nabantu abali in the know. They're like, one, chair yo get de chandi bech tufu. You have to understand, MC Cats, having HIV AIDS is not the last thing that will ever happen to you. It is not a death sentence. We know people who are living positively and living a good life. These kids are out in the streets. Let me tell you, Fame is the worst thing that can humble you down. If you do not take a moment and pace yourself, these are the repercussions of Fame. This is what comes with it. Cats kuvada tukumanyi. Nze sikenda kubyogeranga abalala baumba umba ko cats. You are changing girls the way you change your accent on a daily. Everyone knows that. Now I'm thinking about how big this sexual network is because one, you was with Fear. Fear left you. Y'all went your separate ways. Let's assume, okay, let's not even assume because that's still stigmatization. Fear has been with people too. You have been with people too. Which in return have also been with people too. I was just looking at a huge sexual network. Banange basile kuyini ebintu bye mufira. Buno obuvubuka bwe mulaba obuzunga bwe buti bukatsi. Nga bubabuza buzabulwadde. Mwefeko. And this one goes also out to the boys. These girls who you see looking young. Do you know what shocked me? I was talking to a particular group of people. We're running this whole campaign about helping the girl child and everything. And they told me about the statistics that abana abachasinze okubanga bazalibwa ne HIV AIDS. This, it's not mbuba they ran out there and lived their life recklessly. They were born with it. All the kids, there's an era. 1994, right, to early 2000, there's a huge number of very sick children there. Enda sanga akawala, nga kali 19, kali fresh ku campus, bolowoze kali safe, olwale. Tomanyina bigenda maso, you people, HIV AIDS is real. And for me, what angers me most is for you cats knowing you knew your status and you still took liberties at sleeping with different girls, yet you knew your status. What hurts me the most, I don't think cats will know what they are doing. You know? Tukumanyi cats olimuli abuto. Tukumanyi. This whole is just disgusted me. I tried to find sympathy. I honestly did. Tewali gwosobola kwagaliza bulwadde. And I keep telling you girls out here, you slay queens. That's my hashtag. Tell a slay queen, hashtag teach the boy child. Mubalaba. They keep moving. They're at these parties. They are doing these things. Jerusalem. Now whether he is HIV positive or not, that for me is besides the point. Honestly speaking, that's for me, it's besides everything. This just opened up a whole can of worms into a particular section of our entertainment industry. Because one thing we know in this industry, especially with our male entertainers, y'all recycle girls. Same thing goes for the girls. Y'all recycle men. So if he's HIV positive, na itirayo, na maloku itirayo, na ku itiram, na we no maloku mu itiram, and it's a slay queen generation. Na wa kuali, no, na wa kuali, no, na wa kuali. I'm like, when I tell you people I am tired of this industry, I actually mean it. I do. I've seen so many sick, twisted things in this industry. At times, I feel I'll be scarred for life. Na even to be a cut since I second a call a conclusion ni tebabalimba. Katandi kabutandis. Because Douglas Wanga came out and said, atoyo ye munne, mfanfe. On his Twitter, he's like, guys, MC Cuts is okay. Those videos were a while back. He's doing fine, but thank you for the love and support. Cuts, I pray. I honestly pray that you are not using this, Luachivuru. Because if you are, I wish you a very painful, slow death. Because you will have mocked generations of people trying to fight HIV. You will have mocked generations of people trying to live positive. You will have mocked the entire world using your disease as a point of empathy. Because abalala benjogedde nabo nabo bagambye chechimu ne bagamba ya chandi bachitufu te chandi bachitufu na inge chitufu chirindi chechivulu ayagala chijule. I swear cats, If this is what is happening, I want to wish you a very painful, slow death. Because now this will have taken it to a whole nother level. You came out and made an announcement like that and didn't even think about consulting the mother of your child. Kat, your first baby mama was my neighbor in Chiwatulembi, Tobie Ghana. We all know what she died of. We all know what she died of. Mama, we used to call her mama. So, yo, I know there is showbiz. And I know there is okwe agalo okwe mulisa. And I know depression is real. I know so many things. But I pray to God that this is you trying to look for footing. This is for you trying to garner support to stand and fight whatever it is that you're fighting. I pray to God though. It has nothing to do with your children.
Yes, sir.
I can go on, but I'm going to leave this conversation there because it's still developing. And we are going to find out the details. Eventually. We are going to find out the details. But in other news, young girls and boys out there, this serves as a lesson. Buli mwana gola ba tambula kulinanya, the only person who is not sick is you. You can't trust nobody. Don't trust nobody. Young slay queens are going to kill very many, many innocent boys and girls just because you want a minute of fame. You stupid, reckless boys are going to kill very, very, very many women and men just because you couldn't keep it in your pants. Abana balwade. Abana balwade. I know Christmas is in a few days and this is some stuff you don't want to hear, but Baba mani, waitirake wakati. Obe wafi. Obango inakogo walio mani ya itirayo na we no itirayo. Tell a friend to tell a friend achiwuli tetegeza muno. Go know your HIV status. Just go find out. Because I cannot. I will not. Not today. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Am I sad? Am I? All I care for is the kids, and the kids are okay. Do I want you to serve as an example? Yes, I do. Maybe, with you as an example, it will teach all these young kids and all these young girls to keep it together. Not that you're going to stand up and tell them, Bambi, keep it together, no. Them seeing your life and raving, them seeing you where you are at now, is going to change so many things. So yes, I'm glad you're an example. God sends those two. Anyway. We shall find out the details. For now, I'm not in the mood. I'm not in the mood. @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop under TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's @TinaFierce1. And on Snapchat, that's @TinaFierce1. For now, though, please do not drink and drive. I'm just saying, it's crazy. But enjoy the festivities. I'm out. Peace.